I'm working on this hand knit hat, and as you see, I do have the white and the red. Now what I did was, after the ribbon, I knitted two rows of white, then the next two rows I slipped the first two stitches, knitted the next six stitches in red, slipped the next two stitches of white, knitted the six stitches in red all the way down. I have two stitches on the end there. I do not slip those two. I turn it around. And then, when I'm working from the back side here, when I'm slipping those two white stitches, I am going to bring the yarn to the front so that that flow is on the back side here and not on the front. Now, to work this up on a machine, well, if you want garter stitch, let's put it that way, you would have to knit one row, take your garter bar, take the stitches off, turn it around, move the carriage over, knit another row, take the stitches off, turn it around, move the carriage over. So to me, that's going to be a lot of work. And even with the garter carriage, I am pretty sure those do not slip stitch. They only knit and purl. So that's going to be really hard to work with the garter carriage. So why not just do it stockinette? Okay, it's not going to have the garter stitch, but so what? It's a multiple, as you know, six stitches plus two. I'm going to have two white stitches on the end. This machine is only a 12-stitch punch card. I cannot do that. I could do four and two and do two repeats on the card, which, yeah, that's going to work too. But I wanted to do the six just to see how it comes out. So I'm going to manually select my needles. I set my cam to slip. This is the Elna, which is the same as the Singer 155. The standard machines, or the 24-stitch cards, you could punch a card so it will do that for you automatically. You do not have to manually select it. But then for the machines like the LK150, the KX350, you could manually select these needles to do the slip stitch. And you knit across, well, you see as I go along. So first of all, I'm going to leave the first two needles there. I'm going to take the next set and bring those needles out to hold position. I'm going to go across. And I have two stitches on the end over here. I don't know if it's actually in the screen. So, as mentioned, I have my cam to slip, but I also need to put my side levers forward so it does not knit these needles. It's only going to knit these needles. So I knit one row. And I should have made sure my tail was a little bit longer there, but it's still long enough because I only have to make a knot with that. Now I'm going to take the same needles out to hold. And I'm going to knit back. Next, I take the red yarn out of the carriage and I put it off to the left here because it's on the left of the yarn mast. I put the yellow back in. I put my cam back to stockinette and knit two rows. I take the yellow out of the carriage, put it off to the side, put the red back in. And now I need to offset this. So I had three, four. So one, two, three, yeah. I bring the first four needles out Oops. But I leave two over there, the two prongs on the side there. Now this is going to offset that red. And I have the four stitches over here. Again, I need to put my cam to slip. And as you notice, I did not put my side levers back when I did the stockinette. It knitted those stitches just fine. So now I'm going to knit two more rows. Actually, one row, and I have to select the needles again. And knit back. So here you could see where the red yarn slipped, and then here you could see the two yellow stitches where the red yarn is slipping as well. Again, I took the red yarn out of the carriage, put the yellow in. I need to put the cam back to stockinette, and I'm gonna knit the two rows. Now I'm gonna repeat those, let's see, 2, 4, 6, 8 rows, probably, well, depending on how many stitches you have. Now I have 66 stitches. Now you could decrease for the crown in a couple different ways. There's, instead of doing 8 repeats of this pattern, you could probably do 10 repeats and then knit a couple rows of the yellow and then decrease the stitches in half, move every other stitch to the neighboring needle, put the empty needles out of work, knit 2 or 3 rows, gather bind off. But I like to do this as if it was a hand knit one, and luckily with 66 stitches divided by 6 is 11. So I take the 10th stitch and I move it. Now because I have the second one here and the selvage stitches there, what I am going to do is, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. I'm going to take the 9th needle and move it to the 10th, the 9th stitch, and move it to the 9th ninth needle, move it to the 10th stitch. Nope. 9th stitch moved to the 10th needle. Okay, let's get that right. And this way here, I'm going to have a decrease always on that second, third needle there. But every decrease is always going to be one less. Because of this way, I need to, after I transfer these stitches over, I need to move all the work inward, so there's no empty needles. I'm going to push the empty needles all the way back. Bring all the needles with stitches on them out to hold position. And then, although this is for 12 stitches, I could still do the 6. So I can move 6 stitches at once. And actually, there's a way of using your garter bar to do this as well. So now, and I probably should make sure all these latches are open. Then I go to the next set. I always go to the first empty needle. Now I could probably go one more and have 2 empty needles and move these over, but sometimes it doesn't work too well, and I don't mind sitting here. Yeah, we use the machine to make things faster, but at times we do need them to go slower. Now, when you have the yarn splitting like that, I will go ahead and close the latches so that I could get them off the needles. And that was because there was two stitches on that one there. It kind of split the yarn. So now I have one more here. Then I'm going to start on this side. Although with two stitches right here, I could take my two-prong tool and move it over that way. Now, if you do not have a guider bar or a multi-prong tool like this, just go ahead and use your three-prong tool. Sometimes I find this easier. The yarn doesn't split as much when I'm only moving three stitches at a time. And before you know it, you're done. Okay, so after I finish moving all these stitches inward, I knit two rows. Then I'm going to go one less needle. So then the next one's going to be the eighth stitch to the ninth needle. And then the next decrease is the seventh stitch to the eighth needle. And I'm going to keep doing that until I get down to as low amount of stitches as I can. And then I will decrease the stitches in half, put the empty needles out of work, and knit one row just to do that decrease row, and then do a gather bind off, and then sew up the seam. Now I like to have a long tail, although I didn't really put a long tail in the end here. It's long enough to where I could sew from the bottom up, and I could get somewhere in the middle of the hat. And then that yarn tail at the bottom is not hanging down there. So, okay, I got that. So now I just need to move these stitches over. And I'm going to start with this one here. It's going to be less time to move them over. And I will have the two empty needles here. It is stretching a little bit, but once you get the work off the machine, those stitches will set themselves. It is tight. I'm going to actually use this for the last set. And yeah, it pulled out three extra needles there. So I knit two rows. Let me make sure I have all the empty stitches. I mean, needles, they're full. There's no empty stitches. Knit the two rows. And continue decreasing the same way. So I'm down to 18 stitches. I'm going to knit one row across, and this is where I'm going to decrease in half. So I bring every other needle out. Luckily I have this tool. If not, you're just going to use your single prong transfer tool and move those stitches one over. And actually I'm going to do that for the last three over here. No need to bring those stitches in. I'm going to knit one more row back. And actually, I'm going to knit one more row. I dropped a stitch. I got to fix that. Now, if I had caught this before, I would have had no problem. But no big deal. It'll be hidden. It's right on the top. And to hide it even more, I could put a pom-pom on there. Okay, so now I'm going to knit the one last row. And then I want to do a gather bind-off. Now, I do have the tail at the beginning that's going to go about halfway up. I really don't need this one here to be that long. But what I've done is, if I have a short tail in the beginning, I know for a gather bind-off I need two lengths of what needles I have in work here. So I just go like that, and then I cut a little bit beyond that. And if I had my tapestry needle here, I would just take and get each stitch off. But what I can do is just put the yarn over the hook, pull it through. You only have a little bit there, so that when you pull it through and you pull the needle through, you're able to pull that yarn right out and go on to the next needle. Then all I have to do is sew the seam halfway from the top down, halfway from the bottom up, weave in those yarn tails, or even knot them as long as it's a small knot, and you're all done. So there's the pattern. So there, it's done. Not bad. Now I want to point out, here is the back seam here, as you can see there, and the way this pattern worked up is it looks continuous. And then the top has the decreases, the six decreases. I may have to, at that one area that I dropped a stitch, fill it in with some yellow yarn, or just make a pom-pom and put it on the top. Now, this hat was made more for the brim to stay down. If you're going to put it up, you may need to do a few more repeats of this just to compensate for the brim being folded up. Or, if you don't want rib, you could do a folded hem here and make that really nice and thick.